printer, all the latex printers, come with a full set of generic presets built right into the firmware, okay? These are immutable. They're there, you can use them. They're based on categories, like what I have here is a PVC banner, but you cannot adjust them. We did that intentionally. We want to keep those permanent, so you can't goof those up. You're locked out of them in a sense. Now, what you can do is you can clone them. So I'm going to give you a couple scenarios that might explain your circumstance and then how the cloning will help overcome whatever issues you're having. So you've just bought your latex printer and you have a scrim banner and you have no idea what it is or where it came from, but it appears to be a banner. You've narrowed that down. Great, we have a banner. So you load the banner into the printer. That's fairly straightforward, that's easy. Well, now what do you print with? Well, your first choice, since you don't know what it is and you can't use whatever's on the media locator, use the generic settings. So we have a generic PVC scrim banner that's built into the printer. Now, this generic scrim banner was based on a banner. Somebody made it. And this will work probably 95% of the time with no modifications. Okay, right out of the box, just print to it. I want to explain some of the different offerings there. So with this generic setting, you have 4-pass, 50%. Then you have 6-pass, 80%, and 10-pass, 100%. The resolution is the same in all of those print modes. The clarity of the text, the detail, that's the same. The drop size, that's the same, 12 picoliter. What's changing with 4-pass 50, keep in mind of the speed temperature ink load idea, 4-pass 50 is very fast, not very much ink. So it's going to look a little light. If you go to 6-pass 80, that's 80% density. You've increased your density 30% from 50. So it's going to have a much richer print. It's going to look quite good. 50 is going to look a little light. Now you have a 10-pass 100. That means you're going a little slower, but you're putting more ink down. Again, the color is going to become a little richer, a little more deeper, a little richer saturation. So those are, in a sense, different quality, but not so much the resolution, just the amount of ink you're putting down. Now, the 100% density is going to cost more than the 80% density, which is going to cost more than the 50% density, because you're using a little more ink. But it's also going to give you a little richer quality. Those are the differences there. As your speed decreases, you're able to put more ink down, and your quality, your overall saturation, increases. That's the relationship. So you pick the mode based on what you think your quality expectations, or more importantly, what your customer's quality expectations are. And you have three to choose from. So you load your banner, you choose 6-pass 80%, you're printing along, and you see that, you know, it seems to be kind of warping, like you're kind of buckling. Okay, that means the temperature is too high. The settings on this generic preset are a little bit different than your actual banner. That's completely understandable. Now what are you going to do? Well, you can't adjust it because it's not adjustable. It's immutable. There's no button there. Modify is grayed out. What you do is you take the existing generic and you clone it. You do a complete clone. It's there on the bottom. It says clone. You're going to clone it and you're going to rename it. My mystery banner. Whatever you want to call it. So your mystery banner now becomes editable. Now you can adjust temperature, speed, and ink load, but it's based on the settings that we have in the printer. And when you do that clone, which is right there, and you rename it, now you can adjust the temperature, you can adjust the ink load, you can even create new pass modes. So this, as you notice, doesn't have an 8-pass mode. Well, it might be a smart thing to take the 6-pass and then make an 8-pass, run 80% ink just the same, but lower the temperature. Now what you've done is kept the ink load the same. You've slowed the printer down a little bit, and that's going to give you a window to lower the temperature some, and then everything else will stay the same. Your banner will flatten out. Presto, you've solved the problem. It's really quite easy, but cloning is going to be a part of that. And I want to explain how it worked. And I also want to explain why you can't adjust the default generics, because we did want to fix those so you can't change them and not remember what the original settings are. So cloning is the way to do that. Next, I want to show you in the next video how you can do on-the-fly adjustments, which will help you dial in your temperature and your speed so that you have the perfect setting while the printer is printing. It's called on-the-fly adjustment, and that will let you really dial in for the perfect setting for your particular media.